Hey y'all, so before I get this video started, let me give a quick shout out. These were the first three comments in my last video. If you want to be featured in my next video, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell and come show me some love when I drop a new video. What's up, you guys? It's Kiambra Vaughn, aka Coach Ki, coming back to you with another video. If you are new to my channel, welcome. And if you're not, welcome back. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and also tap the bell so that you are notified of every new video that I post. So as you guys can tell by the title of this video, I'm doing my December budget recap, which I've already created the sheet. My December budget did not end until January 12th. That's why it seems like it's so late, but it's really not. I did go ahead and finish off Paycheck 3's budget. So I'll just do a quick run through of that and then we'll go ahead and do this sheet. I'll go through all of my actuals for each part of my budget and then I'll grade myself at the end. So just a quick rundown. My health insurance, I told you guys, was gonna be more expensive than I thought. I did, before, I think my health insurance was like $165.22, but now it's gone up to $232.11, but it might end up going back down because it's based off of my income. Since I am an agency nurse, I don't have health insurance, so I go through the marketplace, but it's based on my income, and I think that my income is probably gonna end up being around what it was the previous year. So if it ends up being less than what I projected, that number will go down. I did have all the other expenses. So my fixed expenses ended up being $491.64 versus $459.53. As far as what I spent on my variable expenses, I only spent $328.64 versus the $503.33 that I budgeted. I didn't have a whole lot of expenses. It seemed like I did, but I really didn't. I tried to buy some makeup, the new Fenty powder, plus some concealer, and I just can't find foundation of my color. I have a very weird, it's like I have a peachy color to my face. I'm not yellow. I'm not like a cool tone. I'm not red. It's like I'm kind of peachy and I just can't find stuff that works for me. So I ended up taking all of that stuff back. And then I did try to buy another foundation, took that back, that didn't work. And the rest was pretty much groceries. And I did have more supplements than I thought, because usually I'm charged like on the 18th, but they charged me on the 11th this month. I'm not sure why. So I ended up having way more coming out for supplements than I originally thought. And that was pretty much it. So I did finish off everything at the bottom down here. So when I reconciled my account down, I did send an extra $842.81 to my account. I sent almost $650 to my true emergency fund. That's gonna pay myself for February since I'm taking all of February off. And then what was in excess, I put in my miscellaneous/investment sinking fund. So all in all, once I subtracted everything, the fixed expenses, variable, the savings that I had already done, and then what I reconciled my account down to. If you're new here, I always like to start my new budget with $4,000. So whatever's in excess of that in my checking account, I send that off to savings. So that was the amount there. So I ended up saving $151 more than what I thought. And I did have a small Amazon check come in. I did not budget that on camera because it was very small, but I just took the $210, which is 20% for taxes, and I left the rest in my account. And that's how we got back down to $4,000. So let's go ahead and go through these numbers really quickly. Again, I've already done all the totals and everything for the budgeted part. So paycheck number one, I thought I would earn $1,167.38. That's probably my grandma leaving. And my actual was $1,373.17. For paycheck two, I thought I would earn at least $1,350. I earned less than that, and that was because they did not pay me my holiday pay, and that ended up coming on my next check, and I think it was an extra like 90 something dollars. So I would have definitely been over the amount that I budgeted if I would have paid correctly. All right, so paycheck three was $1,786.47. My YouTube check ended up being $338.86. And then I did not budget anything for Amazon, but again, I was paid the $10.52. So let's go ahead and add up the actuals. So $1,373.17. Plus $1,334.54, $1,786.47, $338.86, and $10.52. So I had a really good month of income, but it's only because it was a magic month. Magic months for me usually only happen two times a year, but this year was like a magic year because I had three magic months this year, but that's not typically my income, you guys. All right, so I do want to do the pluses or minuses up here as well, just because I like to see how well I'm estimating my income. That's really why I like to do the recaps. I like to see how well I am estimating my income and expenses, because that's what budgeting is all about. Trying to see how well you can estimate what your money is gonna do for you. $36.47. And then this one is $38.86. $10.52. So $205.79 minus $15.46 plus $436.47 plus $38.86 plus $10.52. So I earned $676.18 more than what I thought. And I'm just doing the math going across to make sure that it works out, and it does. Okay, so now let's get into the expenses. First of all, my rent was $450. I save half of my rent every paycheck, so in the magic months, I just end up saving more. And that pretty much means that by the end of the year, I'll end up with one extra payment, and I'm already a month ahead too. So now at this point, I'm 2 months ahead on my rent. All right, $62.49, that was correct. This one was correct. Insurance was correct. This other one was not. This one was the $232.11. Sideline was correct. My property taxes were correct as well. And so let me go ahead and do the pluses or minus for these, and then we'll get into the variable expenses. $32.11. All right. So if you're new here, the way that I use my expense tracker, I always know my pluses or minuses before I know what my actuals are. So we're gonna go a little bit backwards for this part here. So let's get those out, then we'll do the savings and I will grade myself. Okay. So for groceries, I estimated a $400 worth of expenses for that. And I actually ended up, yeah, that's right. So I ended up still having $65.54. Personal household, I still had $75.53. That expense category is going to continue going down because now that I am wearing my hair primarily blown out and straight, I keep my straight hair for 2 weeks, then I do a blowout 1 week at a time. And then I go back to straight. So it's straight hair for 2 weeks, blow out for a week, blow out for a week. And I keep going like that. So when I wear my hair completely natural, like in its curly state, I typically have to wash my hair every 3 days or so, every 3 or 4 days. So I use way more product. So now I don't have to worry about that. Restaurants, I still had $128.59, and that is why for this current month I did go down quite a bit on that category, which this is 6 weeks worth of budgeted expenses. But I went down because with COVID going on, I don't really go out to eat as much anyway, but I usually only order food out on the weekends. But a lot of times now I've still been having food left over that I've cooked for the week. So I've just pretty much been finishing that up. Shopping, I was over budget $15.64. Gas, I was under budget $44.50. $15.64. What made me over in that category? Let's see. I got some belly rings, got some leggings. Oh, I did buy me a new Xbox controller. That was $43. So pretty much, I just bought clothes and an Xbox controller. Everything else I ended up taking back. Yeah, and then I bought belly rings too. The miscellaneous category, I still had 203.32. I thought I was gonna end up needing quite a bit of money for that category this month, but I didn't end up doing what I had planned. Then supplements, I was over drastically again because I don't know why I was even charged for this stuff so early, but that's okay. It's something that I need, so it doesn't bother me. And then business, I don't think I spent any money in that category this month, did I? No, I didn't. So I still had $100 for that category. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the actuals. So 400 minus 6554. So I spent $334.46 on groceries. For personal household, I spent $99.47. I think that's that cat, yeah. So for restaurants, I spent $46.41. That's actually pretty good. $125 minus $44. Gas, I only filled up twice. I think I filled up twice and then I like topped it off at the end of the month. So that was $80.50. For what category is it? Shopping, I spent, what is that? $165.64. Then for miscellaneous, I spent $146.68. Supplements, I spent $128.88. And then there was nothing spent for business. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the actual column. So what I budgeted for all of my expenses for the month was $2,506.27. That's for my fixed and variable expenses. And then what I actually spent was So I spent $2,030.42. And it should actually be, yeah, that's right, 42 cents. Okay, so I'm just gonna do the plus or minus column real quick. 28.59, 44.50, minus 15.64, plus 203.32, minus 93.88, plus 100. So in total, I spent $475.85 less than what I thought. And I'm just gonna go ahead and do the math going across. Then we'll do the savings, I'll grade myself, and we'll be done. Okay, so as I told you guys earlier in the video, I do plan to take off all of February. So because of that, what my plan was to save as much money, basically any money that I did not spend for this month, everything was gonna be sent to my true emergency fund so that I can pay myself that salary in February. And then I also was gonna save money in the month of January if I did not save enough for February. My goal was to save $22.50 because by the time I take money out for taxes from my YouTube paycheck, that should be able to make up for the other $250 that I'm missing, because all I need is $2,500 to live. You guys can see my actual for this particular month was $2,030. So I can literally live off of $2,500. And my actuals were actually higher because of the rent for the most part. And so we got rent in here. This stock club expense will be gone. My health insurance was a little bit more, but that's gonna be standard. I won't have these two expenses. So if you subtract the expenses that won't even be there, I can definitely live off $2,500. And whatever I don't spend will end up being saved at the end of the month. So let's see. And I forgot to put a part for my taxes. And what I budgeted for taxes was, I knew I was missing something. I can never do nothing perfect no more. It's always something wrong. $75 was what I budgeted for that. Okay, so let's do the tax part first. I ended up saving $67.77 from my YouTube paycheck and then $2.10 from the Amazon check. So the actual was $69.87. Why? $338.86. Why did I think it was gonna be 75? Is the question. That's the question. Oh, because when I did this, so when I did the estimation, I did 25% instead of 20. I don't know why I did that. I never do 25%. Okay, so let's go back up here. So the actual was, I saved less, but I'm just gonna do it in black and white because it's really, I only saved less for that one because I budgeted that part wrong. Okay, so what I sent to savings for my income for February, we did $188.45 the first paycheck. The second paycheck was $667.27. And then in the very last paycheck, I sent $745.74. When I ended up getting Christmas money, I ended up getting $295 worth of Christmas money, and I just sent that to my miscellaneous/investment sinking fund because I already knew that I would have enough to reconcile down to finish off whatever was left. I could have waited to the end of the month, but I didn't. So I sent another $648.54. That gives me $2,250. Dang, I didn't do, y'all, I did this all wrong. I didn't budget anything for that. I'm sorry, this is wrong, y'all. All right, so my actual for my February income was $2,250. Yeah, this is all kinds of wrong. So what I'm gonna do, we're gonna do this. So I saved $1,586.11 minus $2,250. I saved $663.89 more than I thought, plus the miscellaneous/investment sinking fund. So we got $295 plus I sent another $198.27. And I also got another, was that in this paycheck? No, I got paid that on the 14th, never mind. Okay, so what I sent to my miscellaneous/investment sinking fund was $493.27. Of course, I didn't project any of that, so that's all positive there. And then, if I total up, here, $563.14. So the amount of money that I saved total ended up being $2,800. So $2,813.14, and that's correct. So of my income of $4,843.56. I saved 58% of my income. Which is pretty good. So if I had to give myself a grade, let's see. I'm not going to worry about this part. That money ended up coming over here. I don't really know why. I did underestimate my health insurance. That's something that's like kind of out of my control, honestly, because I don't even know how they do that part. I did go over budget in two categories, so I can't give myself an A+. This one wasn't my fault, this one was. So really, out of the few reds that I have, only one really was concerning. So I'm gonna go ahead and give myself an A. No pluses, no minuses, just an A. I think that I did really, really good. I'm very happy that I was able to save all of the money that I needed from my February income this in 1 month instead of across 2 months. So I'll be able to save quite a bit of money this month and then, you know, be able to kind of just chill and relax for the month of February. So that is my December budget recap. If you guys have any questions whatsoever, feel free to leave them down below. Let me know how you guys did for your December budget. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. But other than that, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.